So in this lesson, what I want to talk about are actually RSS feeds and how they can be utilized with WordPress and ultimately enhanced with Feedburner. And just to start off really quickly, what we're going to be talking about is actually what are RSS feeds and how can we benefit from them. And so very simply, since most of us probably already know what RSS feeds are, they're just another way to subscribe to content. And it's a way that users can use third-party apps or websites to be able to read your content on these apps. So they can read a bunch of different websites' content all in one location, so they don't necessarily have to visit your website each time. And so the benefit of this is ultimately continued readership. It allows readers or users to be able to continue reading your website or continue reading your content without physically having to go there. And so that's just good for building an audience. So how can we actually utilize this with WordPress? And the great thing about WordPress is that RSS feeds are automatically integrated into our website. So all you have to do in order to access these RSS feeds is simply go to your domain name slash feed. So for example, if you wanted to visit WordPress.com's RSS feed, all you would go is WordPress.com/feed. So what we see here is actually the RSS feed for WordPress.com. And the great thing about this is all we have to do is just copy and paste this URL into our RSS feed reader, and we're able to subscribe to their content as soon as new content is posted. But for many, this is still very intimidating, right? The RSS feed that is outputted with WordPress is not necessarily the most user-friendly. And so that's why we're going to be using Feedburner in order to actually present this content in a much more user-friendly manner. And so I'll actually show you how to set everything up with Feedburner, but pretty much if you wanted to look at a Feedburner account or look at a Feedburner RSS, is you just go to feeds.feedburner.com/ and then whatever the name of it was. So whatever choice you want to do is perfectly up to you, but I'll show you how to set up very quickly this Feedburner RSS feed. So in order to actually create an RSS feed with Feedburner, or more likely, how to use the interface of Feedburner to display your RSS feed, all we're going to do is simply go to feedburner.com, sign in with our Gmail account, and it's going to be absolutely free. And when we get to this window, all we're going to do is paste in our RSS feed of WordPress, our basic RSS feed, remember just our domain name, slash feed, and we're going to click on next. And when we see in this menu, all we're going to name is our feed title, so name it whatever that describes your website well, and a feed address. And it could be whatever you want. In this case, since the actual feed burner of WordPress is already taken, it's going to add this little extension. So we'll just say that's okay, and we're going to click next. So this URL right here is actually our feed burner URL, so it in fact has installed correctly. And so if you ever wanted anybody to subscribe to our RSS feed, we can just direct them over to here. And simply they would be able to see something like this, and they could subscribe with whatever different options they wanted to, subscribe with Feedly, or simply just copy and paste this Feedburner URL into their RSS feed reader. And that's it. There's many different options that we can actually customize Feedburner, but you can just play around with those in a bit.